Hi, a warm welcome to everyone. Hope you all are doing great. In this class, I'm going to demonstrate on how to load a master data into a BI system. Before we get into the demonstration, let me explain the difference between a master data and a transaction data. In simple terms, I can just differentiate the master data as the data which are not subject to change and the transaction data or the data which are subject to change. Okay? Let me explain to you this set of data. Look at this activity. So this data I will term it as transaction data because the employee ID, department ID, project ID along with number of hours and salary. Here the number of hours and salary are subject to change. So this complete set of data I will always define it as transaction data. Now let me take the second set of data, where the master data. Here the employee ID, employee name and employee location, they are not going to change, right? So these three fields I will term them as master data, and out of these three fields I will take only the employee ID and use it in the transaction data, such that with my employee ID I can always find the employee name and employee location. So I need not necessarily maintain my employee name and employee location in this transactional set of data. So my transactional set of data will always have a key field and the columns which are subject to change. Each key field will have their own set of master data. Just like employee ID, employee name and employee description. Similarly, the department ID, department name, employment description and so on. Now we are going to look on how to load this data. RSA1 is the initial transaction that we need to use in this BI system. So this is the initial page that you are going to get. Go to the info provider as the first page and right click on the top and create your info area as first. So first step during master data upload is creating your own info area. So right click, create an info area. So provide the name whichever you wish to. So let us name it as MASTR_IA, which will be abbreviated as info area. So I'm going to give the same name under the description also, just to maintain consistency and to maintain simplicity alone. So once you have created, you can find the same in this list. Once you have done, you can find the same info area here. Yeah, here it is. So our info area has been successfully created. Now the same info area should have been copied to the info object node. Yeah, here it is. So under info object node, create your own info object catalog. So this is nothing but you are creating a template, right? You are creating a template for storing data. So I name it as MASTR_IOC. So I would like to provide the same value in the description also. So here, this is going to be an info object type of cache process. Since it's not subject to any change, employee ID, master data are always not going to subject to any change, right? I prefer characteristics. If it's subject to any change, I should prefer key figures. So activate it. So I activate it. Here comes my info catalog. So right click and create my first info object type. So this is going to be as employee ID. So this is the employee ID. I'm naming it. I'm going to provide the same in the long description area. So I will continue, and here the data type I would prefer character string. My length is going to be 5 and I'm going to activate the same. So we have successfully created our first info object type. Now be very careful with my other column. So with this employee ID I can always find the employee name and employee description. So I can simply say this employee name and employee location can be the attribute of my employee ID. So I cannot individually create this employee name and employee location as another info object type. Rather than I can create an attribute. I can create this info object type as an attribute. For this creation of info object type as attribute, there are two ways. So since we have two columns, I will show you both the ways of creating this info object type by attribute. So go to the attribute tab of your employee ID. Since it's going to be an attribute of your employee ID, provide a name of your choice. I'm going to provide as MASTR and ename. So yes, it will create as an attribute. and it's like, oh, the name is too long, I have to reduce. So let me reduce the size of the name. So it's NST underscore ename. I hope system accepts it. So I'll continue. Yes, system is accepted. So I will provide the same in the long description and short description. So next step, I'm going to provide this data type, and length is going to be say 10, right? Now if you see here, this attribute only checkbox is right. It has been already checked. So I provided 10 because the length is small in our Excel sheet. Yeah, here, this attribute only is already being checked since I'm trying to create an attribute for my employee ID, right? So I continue. So you can see my info object type has been created as an attribute for my employee ID. This is one way of creating your info object type. The another way is, before that we have to activate it, of course, we have to activate. Hope we get a green signal, I'm pretty confident on that. Yes. Yeah, good. We have got the green signal. Now, go to your catalog, right click on it, and create info object type, but this time it is quite different. How is that? Now right click, create an info object, provide a new info object name, like mstr underscore, it's going to be location, right? So it's going to be LOC, and I'll provide the same under my description column. So once I have provided the same in my description column, now here I'll provide the data type. Let me give a data type of 15 since there was 4. Here. This other tab contains a section called attribute 1D. I'm going to check that box because this info object type is going to serve as an attribute. Right? Later, after creation, I will assign this attribute, I'll assign it to the employee ID. Now, first let me create it. I have activated it and I have created it as an attribute 1D. Remember that. In case of employee ID, I didn't check that box because that's the software info object type. Now, I go to the employee ID info object type and I will go to the attributes section. Before you go, you always need to go to the change mode. Go to the attribute section and add the new employee location which you have created as an attribute. Now, as soon as the entrance press enter, the data has flown. The details are flown. Now try to activate it. So once you have activated, it's all good here. So far we have created successfully the template for this master data. Right? So being created with the template, we'll proceed next. Go to the source system, right click on the source system, create a flat file. This is one way of creating a flat file. Another way of creating a flat file is directly go to the file folder, right click and create it. Both ways you can create. I'll prefer the second one, mstr underscore ss, this is abbreviated as flat file, and I'll provide the same for the logical and source name, and I'll continue with it. Remember, this is a time consuming step in this entire process, so we have to be patient for the flat file creation. And once your flat file is created, it takes some time for flat file creation, and I appreciate your patience on this. So, yes, here, a flat file has been created. So once the flat file has been created, you can see the same appearing in that particular node, in the file node, folder. Here it is. Just double click on it, it will take you to the data source node. The navigation of the node you can see at the left. Now right click and create an application component for your flat file that you have created. This is the mstr underscore ac, abbreviated as application component. I am providing the same in the description. So I will continue. Once I have created the application component, it will appear below. Now, once I have created that, right click and create a data source. This is going to be the container of your data. So I will name it, the same prefix I am using, mstr, so my data source. And the data source, data type is a master data this time. It's not a transaction data. It's a master data. So I'm proceeding with the creation. So I will provide the same data source name in the short description, medium description, and in the long description. Just to make it simple, then I'll go to the extraction tab, provide the delta process. Of course, it's a full upload. Then direct access, there is no DTPs allowed. and then the adapter, it's going to be an update from your local file. Then select the file path, select your master data. Master data is the one which I have showed you earlier, the employee ID, employee name and employee location. And this is the exact file. Please ensure it's in CSV format file. And header rows to be ignored is always one because header rows means the master data has columns like employee ID, employee name and headings, right? So I am about to ignore that row. Since there is only one row, I am ignoring it. So the data separator is always preferred comma, and the exception is going to be double quotes. But comma, I will show you where this comma will appear. So once they provided all these details, they go to the proposal. I just load example data and see whether my data is getting loaded successfully. Here you can see the comma. So my data is getting loaded successfully, and you can see the comma that is separating each column, right? Now go to the field. Here you find format is external. Please ensure it's always internal format that you follow while uploading any data. So I change it into an internal. So this actually appears because of the kind of data the system assumes to be, right? So system generally allots these values based upon the data that they are trying to upload. So it is always good and safe to be an internal format. So once these values are provided, you can go to the preview tab. So go to the preview tab, read the preview data. So in the preview tab, you can always go to the preview tab, read the preview data. So here this last is activated. So activated in the preview tab, now you can see the data being loaded into your data source. It confirms that we have loaded the data into the persistent staging area, right? By persistent staging area data load, we confirm that we have brought the data from the file into the system. Now, as the next step, you have to create an info package. MSTR_IP, which is abbreviated as info package. Save it. Just have a preliminary check so that we have got a green sign here. It's all good. Just check all the values maintained. They are same. Whatever we have entered earlier. Processing is going to be up here. You can find a only PSA. And it's a full upload and schedule. And once you go to the schedule tab, you will find separate icon. Let me take you there. Yeah. So go to the schedule tab. You have a start icon. Click on it and initiate the data transfer process. So this means that you are bringing the data into the PSA table. Yeah, here you've got it. Data was requested. What is in the PSA table is like PSA is the initial slab in the BI system. No data in BI can escape this PSA persistent staging area, right? So once the data source has been created, we have got the data from platform into the data source, and then we have requested it to the PSA. You can also check it by clicking on the go-to menu, go to the PSA table and check the content, right? And you can check the number of entries, it's 5. You can also check the entries inside. Right, it is done through the go-to menu, so we can confirm through this that our data has been loaded successfully to the data source. Now go to the info provider, go to the info area that we have created, right click on it and insert characteristic as info provider, right? Because we are going to pass in the data through our characteristic that we have created, MSTR_that employee ID characteristic that we have created in the catalog. So that is going to be the base. That is going to be the info provider. Based upon our employee ID, we are going to find the other two fields. So I think quite name confusion. We have created the employee ID. What did we name it as? MSTR, I suppose. Let me check out. Yes, we named it as MSTR. So based upon an employee ID one, we are going to fetch out the other two fields. So I have to provide that as an info character, right? So this employee ID, yeah, this is going to be my info object. So through this info object, I'm going to fetch the other two values. So if you expand that, you will get two separate columns. Separate nodes, one for attributes and one for text, and this is a system created one. Now click on the attribute node, right click, and then create transformation. So what is transformation? So transformation is the process of mapping the field of your data source with your master data template. So create transformation. While you select the create transformation icon, you will get a screen as now. Let me try again. Yeah. So master underscore UI, yeah, here it is, attribute. So double click, right click, create transformation. So here in the object type, provide the data, object type of data source, because we are going to get the data from the data source, and provide the data source name. If you are not confident, you can always use the F4 help. Using F4 is always better because it automatically carries the flat file value, source system value to the screen. So yeah, this is the screen I was talking about. Just map the fields which are relevant. Map the fields of your data source with the fields of your master data. So I'm just mapping based upon the template that I have created for the master data. So once I have mapped, I will proceed to activate it. So yes, we are all good to go. Transformation is activated successfully. Now right click on the data transfer process and create the data transfer process. So just check, cross check the data. So once you have done, just change this load into a full load, because you are making a complete full load. And I always prefer the error handling method too. You can keep your own error handling method. It's self explanatory. So just activate it, you will get the execute icon enabled. Just over these, ignore this warning. Execute it. So once you are executed, proceed with the next. I call green here. So five data records, the master data records have been copied. So to ensure we have got the data, right click on the EID, display data. Right click on the master EID. Select all the fields for selection and execute. Now, during execution, you will find only your employee ID. Just because both your employee name and employee location are attributes. They are not a characteristic field. So that's the reason you find only the employee ID. When we are able to see the employee ID in our list, it confirms that our master data has been loaded successfully. Since they were a kind of attribute, it was not loaded. So I hope I was clear enough in explaining you the concept of loading a master data from a flat file into a BI system. So this is how we load a master data. In short, in master data, there is going to be one key field. I will use that key field as an info provider and I will create a characteristic for them. The remaining fields are going to just serve as an attribute. So I will create them as an attribute. I have showed you the ways of creating attributes, and we have pushed the data to transformation and data transfer process. Hope it was clear and was useful. Thank you. Bye bye. Have a great time.